We're here today in the Inez Greenberg Gallery in Artistry in Bloomington, Minnesota, with artwork from a collaborative project on belonging. It was a moment of reckoning after the 2016 election. It was a moment when I started to question my place in the US, and I began to feel othered. And so in that feeling, my instinct was to reach out to another artist.
For me, I'm a queer artist, and so I have had my own moments, specifically within the Trump administration, of worrying about what sort of rights and privileges that I might or might not have. So for me, I come at it from a slightly different angle, but also very much so think about belonging and how I fit in. So there was this sense of us, you know, me knowing and being from a place and kind of exploring Milwaukee in that way, but then Nirmal, you know, moving to Milwaukee, and so there was this ongoing conversation that we would have about where we're from and when does it feel like home.
And also it's about, it became a portrait of a place and the city too, so it was kind of this way of exploring the city through documenting and performing within those places that actually eventually led to a feeling of belonging.
Thinking about our collaboration also, I feel like we both went out on in kind of this very uncomfortable zone. So my work is very set up and staged, everything's lit, everything is exactly where it should be. But it felt like just Nirmal performing within the space, and then whatever serendipitously happened was kind of the right mode for making. And I always get permission, I always
stage
things. So for me to shoot in a much more journalistic manner, even though these are not journalistic photographs, but in that way, that mode was incredibly uncomfortable for me. And then I think for you to perform in front of the camera and be subject was really...
Yeah, and within a public space, there were some places where it was completely natural and I didn't feel uncomfortable, but there were definitely quite a few spaces where I totally felt very uncomfortable. So it was a weird experience and demanded a lot of courage. I think this is the most courageous work I've ever done. As we were working together, we started working on this other body of work that became a natural progression. There is a boardwalk in Milwaukee where American history is engraved on the wooden planks. We were looking and seeing like how history is written and how there are so many stories that are left out of written history, people of color, women. And I did a 30 meter rubbing of major sections. And then that became eventually a prop to do performance-based photography and video.
And in the portraits with Nirmal wearing the timeline, there's this reckoning that's happening. There's like, you know, thinking about how we're born into the middle of a timeline, we're just born into it. And so that wrapping it up and physically kind of wrestling with it is, I think, what is happening within these photographs.
And as an immigrant, I think even more so, we are plopped into the middle of a timeline, and we have to learn what the history is of the country that we are now in, and we don't have a choice whether to own it or not. So there were so many instances in American history that I wanted to reject, and there were so many that I really wanted to embed myself in. And so that's what these photographs kind of demonstrate, is the struggle to either embed myself or change it in some way, or reject it, or struggle with it.